Welcome back into our Studio 10 kitchen here with Lucy Greer from Greer's Markets and Catering, making a classic red beans and rice, of course, the big Cajun cook-off this Saturday. Mm-hmm. So you wanted to make kind of a Cajun dish, right?
Yes, getting everybody in the mood for Saturday.
Awesome.
And it's really, really easy recipe. My mom made red beans and rice growing up and always loved to have it for supper. And it's just so easy to put together.
That's cool.
And what we already did was we browned a pound of Kaneka over medium-high heat. Just let that get a little bit of color on it. And then we added three ribs of celery and one small onion and one green bell pepper, and we just let those veggies soften up. And I also added a couple of teaspoons of syrup just to kind of give it a little bit of sweetness, because we're going to add a little bit of heat too.
Ooh.
So now it's been on medium high heat to let those veggies cook, and we're just going to add a couple of spices before we add the beans.
What you add in there?
That is half a teaspoon of dried thyme and half a teaspoon of ground sage. And I have 2 teaspoons of, I'm using Tony's Creole seasoning, but you can use whichever one you want. And then
these just to give it that Cajun flavor?
Yeah, it is. And that has salt in it, so I'm not adding additional salt. So that was 2 teaspoons of that. And then this is just 1/8 teaspoon of cayenne pepper.
I was about to say, I smell pepper. I was just about to ask you that. Did any of those have pepper in it?
And yes.
I can smell it.
And so that 1/8 teaspoon of cayenne pepper, this is going to give us a pretty moderate heat level, because I don't want to knock anybody's socks off. But you can certainly add additional either cayenne, or you can add additional hot sauce, you know, whatever you'd like. But this will give you a little bit, a good level of heat. And now I'm going to add the canned beans. You can certainly get a dried bag of red kidney beans, and all you would do is just rinse those off, soak them overnight, and then you toss them in here. But you would have to just extend this cooking time. This, by using canned beans, it's just a really quick, we're just gonna let it simmer for 20 minutes. But if you did wanna use dried beans, you can certainly do that too. You'll just extend that, you know, by about an hour.
And all these things you brought with you, are they available at Greer's locations?
Oh yeah, definitely. I'm using, or most of the time I use our private label Best Choice brand.
Yeah.
It is wonderful. It's just compared to national brands, and it will save you, you know, a little bit of money, and it's just
and it's almost just as good as the other brand.
And
you can't
sometimes
really tell
it's even better. Actually, it's funny because I've noticed before, and then I heard somebody else say the other day, the Best Choice raisin brand actually has more raisins
than Kellogg's.
Because I thought that, and then somebody said it the other day. I was like, oh, yes, it does. So anyway, sometimes they're better. And now I'm just going to add 1 can of tomato sauce.
Now you got
sauce.
Me wanting to go do a test. Now I'm going to go buy both, and I'm going to start looking to
I
see
love
the
raisin
raisins.
Brand. It's really
good stuff, yeah.
So on those beans, I was just 3 cans of the kidney beans, and on 2 of the cans, I just put it in with the juice, and 1 can I drained. So that's going to give us the perfect consistency. So now that we have everything in here, we're just going to stir it, and we're going to bring it up to a boil, and then reduce it and just let it simmer for about 20 minutes, and then it'll thicken up really nice for you, and it'll be ready to serve up your rice.
Well, with that note, I think we're going to wrap this up, Lucy. I know that's the worst news the viewers can hear when we have to end the Lucy Greer cooking segment.
Thank you.
It was a real pleasure having you back on the show, as always.
It was fun.
And remember, you can go visit any Greer's locations to get these ingredients. We will have them all posted on Fox10TV.com. You just click on the Studio 10 tab. We'll be back to wrap up this Emmy Award-winning edition of Studio 10 since Joe and I are hosting it after you see this.